Back home now, and do we pay too much land tax in this country? What about stamp duty? Joining me live is the Real Estate Institute of New South Wales Chief Executive Officer, Tim Mckibbin. These are questions which float around a lot in this country. Do we pay too much land tax?
We pay too much tax generally across property, I'm afraid, Tim. When you look at the cost of new property, so somebody who buys a new constructed property, if we look at that, consumers don't recognise that we're paying around about 40% of the total cost is in taxes and charges. It's not very transparent, but that's how much we pay. And that's levied across all three levels of government.
Look, is there any light at the end of the tunnel? We always hear at all levels of government talking about easing taxation because of cost of living and the housing crisis, both for those trying to buy properties, those renting.
Gee, I'd like to be able to give something uplifting on an early on a Saturday morning, but unfortunately I can't. From what I can see, that there's not going to be too much light at the end of the tunnel. In the budget papers, I stumbled across one other comment where the Treasurer had said, and it's in a single paragraph, I think, where the Treasurer had said that he was concerned about the cost of insurance for the emergency services levy because he believed that that insurance was unaffordable. And so what he's planning to do is to move that cost across onto property. So he's going to have an additional tax on property, who clearly can afford it.
Government building homes, is that good or bad?
Any homes that we build, I think, will be welcomed by the community. We really don't care. We're so desperate for housing stock that we don't care where the homes come from. However, I think the government's role in our community is as a regulator. They should be protecting the consumer and looking at systems and processes so that we're bringing a quality product to market. But unfortunately, that's not what's happening. We've got councils that can take far longer to approve a property to be built than it actually takes to build it. So I noticed in the budget also that we're going to be giving additional resources to the planning area, which is great, and I'm thrilled about that. However, it still doesn't hold councils accountable for what they're doing and how fast they are processing the development application. So that is a continual problem. In relation to foreign investors, I think it's politically popular to be increasing taxes on foreign investors, and I think that's a multifaceted discussion. But if I was a tenant desperately looking for a rental accommodation, I don't think I would really care whether or not my landlord was a foreigner or a local.
Just with councils, should planning completely rest with them? You just mentioned it can be quite protracted. It can be very financially disadvantageous for people trying to either build a new home or put an extension on when this is just taking so much time because they can't plan.
Yeah, look, a great question and one that I think needs to be asked more loudly than it currently is. Unfortunately, when you look at planning within a council area, there's a lot of local politics in it. So you've got people in that particular community who can be in minority, but very, very vocal. And as a consequence of that, councils are in situations where they are politically forced into not being able to make good planning decisions based on the needs of the state rather than the needs of their particular community. Now, recently we heard government talk about releasing land over the top of and adjacent to transport routes like the train, for example, and that's a great idea. That's something that was glaring at us for years. So we need to be building high quality, higher density living accommodation next to those sorts of transport routes so that people can live there, they can come down and use the public transport to get to their work, try and alleviate the need to own a car. There's lots of really, really good ideas that are coming internationally and for that matter also within Australia about what our future accommodation needs should be. We can't just keep going further and further west from Sydney. You know, that's got limitations and it's also meaning that people are travelling already 2 hours a day each way, and that's certainly not ideal.
Yeah, and that's replicated in cities right across Australia. Tim, love to get you on the show again real soon. Thanks for that.